So the players are now picking their characters.
Yep.
We lose Ferrex with Shino.
Shino, interesting.
Pain and Hinata.
Yeah, let's see who Young Sensei picks. Pain and Hinata are really good supports. Let's see how he'll meld in the tag switching too.
So this game has different type of characters. Shino, which is the main character that Ferrex just picked, he's a ranged character.
Yeah.
Which means he doesn't have a powerful melee, but he can attack from, you know, anywhere from the screen. Yeah. He has a crazy range, as his name implicates, and it should be really interesting to see.
Yeah, and it looked like Young Sensei was going for Kasame, but it looks like he's changed to Sage Hashirama.
So in this game, the characters have multiple jutsus, which are like special attacks, and multiple ultimate jutsus for some of them, which is like the ultimate attacks. You can only select that for the main character in the team.
Yep.
So what Young Sensei just did is that he picked Hashirama because he has a very useful jutsu that you can only use if he's the main character.
Yes, the Senju army. Let's see how he's going to use Hashirama.
All right, so Pain is a defensive support. It protects you from everything in the game.
Oh, it looks like we're getting a little bit of air cancels with Shino. Shino tried to tag, didn't work. Hashirama was ready with the block.
So this is the special thing that I was talking about. Hashirama lingers a lot, it's pretty powerful.
Yep, Hashirama was able to utilize that jutsu and send Kisame in. Oh, it looks like Roshi got the jutsu off, and we got off with a grab. Nice.
All right, so in case you don't know about it, the yellow gauge is called a substitution bar.
Yep.
Basically, it allows you to dodge and get out of combos.
Ooh,
you only
nice
have four.
Counter.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
The counter is this white flashy effect that you can see. It allows you to push back the opponent to release pressure.
You don't see a lot of people use Hashirama's tilt so confidently. Hey,
that's the bounce effect. Nice. In this game, whenever your team gauge is loaded up, your teammates get additional effects.
And you guys would have seen just there, it's an addition to Storm 4, burning environmental effects have been added, so. Nice. So Roshi missed that jutsu. Let's see how this is going. I must say, though, they are kind of staying even.
All right, so Young Sensei's guard is actually in the red, which means he could get guard broken.
Yeah,
and he has to be very careful. But so is Ferrex's.
Oh, could this be a cancel? Oh. Young Sensei has to be really careful. He's got no subs now.
His guard just broke. That's going to be very dangerous.
Ooh, he's lucky that he was able to recover. Looks like Shino's utilizing the air jutsu.
All right.
But Young Sensei has still been knocked off his green bar. So his health is into the second half.
Oh, Sparex trying to go for a combo grab, but he failed. He whiffed.
Oh, nice counter to get rid of Hashirama as well.
He has to be very careful. His guard is about to break again, but he hides behind his jutsu. It's lingering, so it's a really good defense.
Yeah. It looks like they're both distancing and like pacing themselves, aren't they?
Yeah.
I wonder how this is going to turn out.
Oh, so Young Sensei is awakening, and there's a transformation in the game.
See, Young Sensei has been able to allow his Roshi to transform and give him the upper edge, but it seems that Shino's trying to hold his own. He should be really careful. Young Sensei has no subs, but now they're even with subs.
All right, but Young Sensei is about
to die. Can Young Sensei get a comeback?
Extremely careful.
Oh, let's see.
Oh my God, he's pitched back to Awakening.
Oh, just the Awakening is gone.
The next attack that actually gets to Young Sensei is going to hand him.
He has to be really careful with the timer going down from 8 seconds. Could this be a comeback?
Oh my gosh! The guard break deal.
The guard break ultimate is slightly weaker, so we do not know how this ends.
But wait, that's not ending the match because you have an Awakening debuff. Once it ends, your damage is lower. That won't kill him.
The time's out! He could have won! If he somehow was able to get that without a guard break.
Actually, he would have won if he had used the power-up item that you can see.
If he had used the power-up, his attack would have gone up, and he could have done that. Maybe it was a little bit of panicking on his side.
So the items that you can see on screen that are displayed at the bottom of the screen can be used with the directional inputs.
Oh, nice. And they're back to being
all right. That's a very close round.
So as Slate was saying, the directional buttons can be...
Yeah, you can use different items. The down item for Master Roshi is... a power up, which allows you to do a lot more damage. Yes. You would have won the fight if you had thought about using it.
Yes. But I do love the way that the round system in this game keeps it intense. So although...
Yeah, one thing interesting to note is that you do not get back your health after one round.
Yes. Which is slightly unorthodox from other fighting games, but it still raises the hype levels of this game.
Yeah, some fighting games do that. I believe Killer Instinct does something with that.
Okay. I had no idea. I can't even call you in that.
Ooh, all right, the bounce back
was really
is
nice.
Back.
Oh, he got a sub down. It seems like Spyrex is using his Shino to utilize the air combos, the air jutsu, should I say.
Yeah, so really Shino's well. Melee combos are really weak in terms of damage, but they can be extremely useful if you have the right supports, which is the case in this team. With a strike back, which is like the bounce effect that you can see sometimes, those short melee combos are deadly.
They are deadly.
Because they are so fast.
They take up more health.
They do no damage by themselves, but with a bounce effect, they can lead to devastating combos.
Oh yeah, that's what I mean. With the strike back being added and all that, it could be really good. Especially because people know it's short. People
Both players only have two subs left. I mean, now Jung-sensei has none, but the guard of Spyrex is about to break.
Oh,
that might be it.
Tried it. Oh, yes. Young Sensei has no subs. He has to be really careful. And Kisame, if he can get off that jutsu from the guard break. Young Sensei even. Oh, if he could, he has to be really careful.
So Young Sensei is using his ultimate attack to get rid of Shino's jutsu.
Yes.
That lingers for so long.
But other than that, Spyrex seems like he has it in the bag so far.
Just saved Spyrex. He was in a really bad situation here.
Spyrex is still in the green bar. He could still take this. Bro. Bro, no subs. Look at this.
All right.
Young Sensei has to be really careful.
It looks really bad for Young Sensei, but if he manages to awaken, he might take this.
He might awaken. He might try something else. Oh, it seems like he's trying to awaken. I don't think Spyrex is going to allow that so easily. Oh, and is God sensitive?
Oh my
he's
God, awakening
the
again.
Awakening. Let's see. Can he get a comeback? This would be
he only has two
epic.
Subs. Yeah, he only has two Ooh. Subs. I don't think he's going to be able to. Yeah.
I think it's over. But... I think it's over. Unless he can get him off the green ball and get... Oh, he's bringing subs down. I think
Pain is... Wow. Oh my God.
Oh, did I speak
oh my
too
God.
Soon?
He canceled the support of Inata.
Oh, he's off the green ball.
He's
Look
getting
at
back
the
his
damage.
Subs. He's getting back his subs. Oh my God.
Look at the damage.
Oh my God.
No!
Oh my
Are
God.
Are you kidding me? I literally gave up hope, yo.
Oh my
Defining
God.
Moment. What the heck just happened?
That is what you call a sick comeback.
Yo, look, he knows. Oh my God, what the heck
oh
just happened?
Oh my God, my heart is beating
my
so bad.
Yo, congrats, that was nice.
Oh my God, that was insane.
Nice job.
His subs came back at the last second.
He had no subs while he did all that, too.
Yeah.
I feel Spyrex got too comfortable, and that's what happened.
I think it was relying on Inata, because what makes Inata so strong is that she has, you know, three attacks, consecutive attacks. And so if she had been able to, because there's something as cheap damage in this game.
Exactly,
so he would have died. Young Sensei would have died.
Exactly.
Here, and...
Oh, that's crazy.
And you got to be lucky, because Inata is not supposed to be canceled that easily. But the size of the awakening actually canceled Inata's support.
Yeah.
And that's when the matches...
But let's be fair to Spyrex. If anyone had that amount of health, they would have thought they had that in the bag. So to be fair, it was understandable why he maybe dropped his guard a little bit. Because he thought, you know, hey, I've got a green bar. This guy's got no subs and red bar. Like literally probably 20%. So,
yeah, I think. And with Inata support and Pain, that is defensive against everything. That is...
They would have done tip damage. He knew that literally Roshi had no choice. Roshi's awakening had no choice but to just go in. But at the same time, if he had blocked, like you said, chip damage would have happened. So,
The giant awakening, something new in this game, is that you can actually counter them. So as you could see, you could freeze the giant awakening, and you could still do a combo. So he had no sub, and he still went for it. That was high risk, high reward. That was really intense.
Yo.
So.
Yeah, actually, I was proven wrong. I was proven wrong.
So it's a best of three guys, so they're getting ready for the second round.
It's not over. Let's see what happens.
And remember, anyway, it's a double elimination tournament, which means every player is going to have to lose twice to actually be permanently eliminated from the tournament.
Exactly. So you were allowed to lose once. It doesn't really matter. But like we said, even for this particular match, it's not all over. We got matches coming up. So That's what we have to look forward to. So this is what we were talking about at the beginning, guys. This game is super fast-paced, as you can see. It's beautiful. And it's a game that pretty much you can't just drop your guard at any point because things happen so fast. You got to be able to utilize everything right from the direction.
Exactly, and it's never over.
It's never over.
It is never over. You can always come back in this game. So the awakening is here. You can only transform when your health is actually pretty low. So it's intended to be a comeback mechanic.
Exactly.
But it's not a win button either because, you know, it's so...
It's got its huge risk as well.
Exactly, because the opponent knows that you're going to try to be more aggressive.
Exactly.
Because it's a limited transformation in time. So
you're a large Marja. You're a larger character, which allows hits to hit you. I need to stop this. Which allows hits to get to you, you know, really easily. Anyone can just get you.
Yeah, it's really hard.
So when
you turn. Okay, so every character has a different transformation. Some are giants. Some are just evolved forms. So as for the giant characters, they do lose a lot of mobility. So
yeah.
That's what you were trying to say. So they get more vulnerable to a lot of attacks.
Yeah.
It's pretty hard to dodge.
Pretty much. It looks like the first he went for Sage mode Naruto.
All right, so Spherix is going for Minato.
He's
the father of Naruto.
Hey, the Zenju army.
All right.
And then we got Minato of Spherix.
I believe Young Sensei is picking the same character, which should not be happening.
Like we said at the beginning, the rules of this game, well, of this tournament, should I say even?
Yeah, we changed the rules of the tournament.
Changing it to not allow you to use the same characters over. So, let's see what happens. Okay, Minato versus Mr. Senju for now. Let's see what happens. He's got Choji, Hinata, and Senju Hashirama.
But to be fair, Spherix also picked Hinata again. So.
Picked Tenten and Hashirama. So let's see how this goes.
So Choji is a dash cut support. Basically, when his strong gauge effect is up, it means that he's going to block incoming dashes from your opponent. So it's extremely powerful in this game because dashing is the only way you can get close to your opponent really fast,
mm-hmm.
unless you're playing a character that has a great range.
And this game from the previous game allows you to do a super dash, which I don't know if it's the official name, but allows you to charge up your dash and allow you to get to the other side of the map and just trick your opponent. Fake out, you know, go faster, so...
All right, so...
Nice, full combo.
So far, yep.
Took it.
Young Sensei is getting his subs back. Yeah.
He was strategizing, I guess.
So Madara is one of the greatest melee range in the game. So
yep.
he technically doesn't have to dash to get his combos going, but he can be countered easily, so he has to be careful still.
Yeah, Minato has been a fan favorite of a lot of online players ever since Storm 3, so people know how to use him really well, but a lot of his fundamentals have stayed.
Young Sensei is having a bit of issues handling the pressure from Spherix.
I think Spherix is not knowing what's going to happen.
Yeah, he won't let him awaken again.
He's like, hey, going down. Except that Madara in this form, I believe, does not have a giant awakening.
Okay, wait. Let's be careful now.
Spherix
only has one sub.
I am wrong. I think he does, right?
Okay, Hinata got cancelled again, but Madara's combo whiffed, so he was not able to conclude his combo. Right, both players sitting with four subs each.
I've noticed a lot of the matches, well, the two matches that have happened. I've noticed not much team switching has happened.
No, basically, when you're playing against good opponents, you get used to a certain playstyle, right?
Exactly.
So tag switching into another character can be a bit... can make you lose your senses, and yeah. Mm. Then you have to relearn how to play the opponent with that new character.
Fair enough. I don't think any of them are going to take any chances. Young Sensei has to be very careful. He has no sub. Oh, yep.
Yep, well, Spherix takes it.
I guess he takes it. I should have warned a little earlier. That was my issue.
Ooh. Yep, he whiffed the counter.
So for the people who are watching right now, the icon showed next to Minato means that at the beginning of the round, he cannot awaken, even though he's at the right health to do so, until that red bar, red circle, goes down.
Exactly. So as you can see, Young Sensei is not trying to dash with his Madara. He's trying to use his melee attack right away because he knows the range is so great.
It seems like Sparx is keeping his distance so that he can kind of psych out Young Sensei.
Exactly.
Probably trying to go for a double round.
Minato's tilt works like a shuriken, so he can throw it from the full screen range.
Nice cancel, by the way.
It is going to be extremely dangerous for Young Sensei right now.
Oh, yeah, very dangerous. He has no subs. Minato can extend just like
and
that.
And he canceled.
And canceled,
yeah.
And that's savage.
Okay, so if you throw shurikens and you're open,
if you throw shurikens,
you cannot awaken.
Oh, Young Sensei is going to have happened. The savagery is real, people.
Yeah.
It's real. Oh, whoa, is this a double round win?
Yep.
This is one of the things that makes Storm 4 really great, because it means that players that really want to show they're on top of things can do things like that, like a double round win. And with your health being kept the same, it means that, you know, pretty much different to some fighting games, you have a little bit of a disadvantage in the next beginning round.
Exactly. So both players won their match. So now it's going to be the final round for the first best of three best tournament.
Yeah. See how it goes down. It's interesting. I think Sparx realized his mistake in the beginning.
Yeah, he went for a melee character this time. That was much more aggressive. Young Sensei had no idea how to handle that pressure.
Thinking about it now, Shino is kind of a difficult character to use if you're trying to be an Awakening.
Yeah, so what you have to know is that ranged characters' attacks do not work on Awakening characters.
Yeah, exactly. They get deflected, kind of, right?
He's still very good thanks to his melee and his jutsu that lingers.
And it's just that Shino's got really short combos, so it makes it very difficult to kind of just...
Sparx would have tried to tech switch into another character, but I think he did not expect...
He didn't expect that comeback to be so strong.
Exactly. But he was much more confident in the second round, the second match, and a double round elimination, so...
Fair enough. But he was able to hold his own in this one. I think that Young Sensei had to come up with another strategy other than trying to use the Awakening to kind of like aid his win.
Yeah, and the Sam Sparx was ready for it, so he was trying to prevent
it
at any cost.
He's not going to make the same mistake twice. As you guys can see on the screen, one win to Sparx, one win to Young Sensei. Let's see who they pick this time.
All right, so Young Sensei is actually going... Oh, I thought he was going for Minato. Never mind.
All right, we're going to see who he's going to pick. But I think that if Young Sensei can get Sparx to be vulnerable in terms of substitution bars, he might be able to pull off a win.
Well, Sparx is a really good defense, because he knows when he's out of sub, he knows the opponent is going to try to dash him. So that's why he's using the counter. So
you guys,
if Young Sensei wants to win this, he's going to have to bait counters.
Exactly. You guys who are watching know that he distanced himself, like you said, when he realized he didn't have subs. Whenever we say subs, we mean substitution bars. And he distanced himself to kind of counteract that.
Yeah, and you have to know that the counter, the flashy white effect that you can see, actually makes you vulnerable when you use it if it does not connect.
Exactly.
So it's a very risky move, but that can pay off greatly.
And what I believe they've changed for this game, like you said, is range characters, their projectiles cannot affect awakenings, just like normal weapons, right? So like kunai and shuriken.
Exactly.
Which means that you can't run away and just throw that if, for example, say that Sparx wanted to win that last match. So this game has made it tougher to beat awakenings, but at the same time, they still have their own vulnerability. So it seems like they finalized on characters.
Minato. Yep, Minato with Shino.
Yep. And Young Sensei.
And Hinata again. All right.
Young Sensei is going for Pain and Minato.
All right, so both teams are extremely aggressive. I took Shoji, my bad. I thought it was Shino, my mistake. They look nothing alike. It's okay. It's just Shino that got a bit of weight. It took a bit of weight. It's okay.
Yeah, it changed. Probably complete makeover.
All right.
They're going all out. Look at the clashes.
So.
All right.
We have Sparx sitting with only one sub, but he just... Oh my god, it whiffed. It whiffed.
He whiffed again.
I'm not sure what's going on. He whiffed twice in a row. It was unlucky for Sparx.
It seems like Sparx has got that cancel down to a T, you know? that cancel with Minato to extend his combo, yeah. And he utilizes that, or really does that, by using the directional buttons.
All right.
So what Pain was doing right there.
Pain, as Ultimate Jutsu, actually goes from the full screen range. So he was trying to put some pressure on the guard of Spherax.
Ah, fair enough. I was talking about the almighty push in the air, like from the other side. Maybe
sick counter that once again, Spherax has whiffed his combo.
Ooh, Spherax is not falling for the almighty pushes. And Hinata is a good support for pressure.
Okay, so this game has something called Tilt. It's when you tilt the joystick forward and press the attack button, you get to do an additional special move. Pain's Tilt is actually really useful in this game. It's the almighty pull that you can see. It attracts everything to you. It's really good. You can deflect supports. It can allow you to combo the characters. It's very effective.
Am I right in saying in the other game it was like a crab?
It was different. I think in the last game, the previous game, they actually made it this way.
Okay. Ah. Minato's is also really useful because it can get you from the other side.
So as you can see, Young Sensei is having a lot of issues right now because when he's trying to dash on Spherax, he's blocked by Shoji. That counter,
ooh, that counter
perfect
saved
timing.
Him from Choji and Minato's rush.
Exactly. Sadly, when he's playing Pain, Pain is the one that has the bounce back effect, so his counters are not as threatening as they could be. But you just switch to Minato, which...
Interesting. Yeah. They switch. Like, I was about to say, this is the first time. Oh, we sent out Minato to fake out and get...
So both players lost their... their strong gauge.
It looks like they're both putting in really good pressure on each other.
Hinata is probably one of the best support in the game for pressuring guard. Because he lingers for so long. It attacks three times in a row.
Yeah, she's a really good pressure support.
Alright, he can now awaken. Young Sensei will try probably to go for a guard break right now.
Ooh, nice! Did you see the ultimate? He did the almighty push.
All
cancelled
right.
it. Just to get a bit of pressure off. Nice.
Okay, so it's closer than he would
It's
seem.
Getting really
yeah.
close.
Spherax only has two subs right now.
And the timer is going down, which means they're really extending these
Young Sensei is probably going to lose this to the timer.
Oh, Awakening. Ooh, with 5 seconds.
Let's
see how this
only
goes.
Only one sub for Spherax.
Oh, nice! I didn't see the jutsu hitting.
Yeah.
Oh, damn. Oh, he tried it.
That was a good try. But yeah, now this time. All right. Oh, Spherax's guard is about to break. He has to be really careful right now.
Yeah, he has to be really careful.
All right, he took some damage. And Hinata once again saving Spherax. So good. What a good support.
Spherax has been able to make substituting very difficult for Young Sensei. So sub-management is a little difficult on Young Sensei's part.
Yeah, he's... Oh my god, and
they're
gonna
even now.
Oh my god!
Nice. Well,
that was extremely lucky. Usually when you're caught in a combo, your support will also get caught in a combo.
Exactly.
And that was so lucky right now.
It's hit and miss in this game, isn't it? Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't.
Yeah.
And like, it keeps you on edge.
I think Minato's combos are... Like, they can be really good, but they tend to whiff a lot.
Yeah.
So that's probably the reason why.
You
so Spherax is sitting with only two subs. He's trying to gain time by throwing shurikens from far. My god!
Oh! I did not see that coming. Sorry for the late reaction, people.
Okay.
But I did not think that.
So sometimes when you're performing an action like throwing a shuriken or landing on the ground after a jump, you cannot actually sub or block.
Yep.
So Spherax did not expect that ultimate jutsu. That is sick.
You have like a millisecond point where you're
all right. Young Sensei has to be very careful because he only has one sub. Spherax is... Oh my god. Okay.
This
is going to be... Young Sensei is going to get his subs back. If he doesn't sub, he's going to get his four subs back real soon. Oh my god!
Oh, nice.
That is a big mistake that he just did. I think that might cost him the match.
Spherax noticed that Young Sensei had a sub, so he decided not to go in for the kill, and he's canceling a lot. Yes, now they're both to even.
Oh
subs,
my god,
so
he's gonna go for an ultimate. Oh my god, he's trying to dash!
He shouldn't have dashed!
Shoji blocked him!
He shouldn't have dashed. Now Young Sensei has got no.
Sick jutsu canceling
beautiful.
To the grab.
That was really beautiful.
He has to be so careful now, Spherax can kill him really easily. Once again, Shoji as he's getting his subs back. Okay.
Oh, nice pressure to break the guard.
Yeah.
Using Hinata, like you said, as an amazing freaking pressure.
Awakening.
That was it. Let's see how this goes down. This has been a Young Sensei's ticket from the since the beginning. So let's see how
anything
this goes
can
down.
Go. Spherax still has his support gauge up, which means it's still protected by Shoji.
The
anyone can win. Do not panic, people. But how do you not when there are so
great
many things at stake?
He has Hinata support, so this time it might be very useful. There you go.
The Moolah. Do not let it get in your way.
Oh my god, this is really intense here. Both players are so close.
Oh, look at the intensity. One sub. Same health, same characters.
Oh my god.
Both no subs. How is this going to turn
god,
out?
This is
crazy. We got Spherix, Young Sensei. Who's going to win
and
this?
It looks like Spherix takes it.
Nice. Spherix.
Hinata for the win.
Ever since Hinata, right? Hinata. She should take the damn trophy.